Hi, I'm Matt Darr, an ag engineer with Iowa State University, and today we're here to talk about vertical tillage tools. Vertical tillage have been around for a number of years and are an excellent way to manage stocks and other residue both in the fall and the spring. They provide a lot of options for how aggressive or conservative you want to go with your tillage practices. It can be an excellent solution to pinning stocks and maintaining residue to prevent soil erosion or other reduction in ground cover. Particularly corn stalks can become a real problem when you're planting if you're not able to adequately move them from the row or if they're too long and become impinged within the crop furrow. There's three things we want to consider when we think about the selection of what vertical till tool is the best fit for you. Number one is thinking about the types of blades or cultures that exist on the machine. If you're in an area that has wetter, heavier soils, you're probably going to go with a blade that's got a little bit of a concavity to it in order to move some additional soil and be a bit more aggressive as it operates. If you're in a condition where you've got highly erodible ground or slope ground that you're doing some vertical till on, then a lower concavity blade is going to move less soil and help you maintain better rooting of stalks into the ground and help prevent soil movement through water erosion. The second thing to consider is the gang angle and the adjustability. When you're running in the fall, it's typical to maybe go a little bit more aggressive to help mix and chop up of the residue, particularly corn stalks. And in those cases, you're going to be looking for a tool that's going to have the option to adjust to a higher gang angle. On the market today, you can get tools that start as low as 0 degree gang angle or no angle, all the way up to aggressive tools that go 12 to 15 degrees and start to operate a little bit more like a tandem disc. Adjustability is key though to make sure that you've got a tool that fits the range of your needs and can go as aggressive as you may want to in the fall, but also can narrow up and go less aggressive in the spring depending on the weather conditions that you have. And the third thing you want to think about are the attachments that go on the back. And there's a wide range of options from baskets and rollers that do a couple things for us on the back side of the vertical till tool. First of all, they help to level and ensure that soil surface is firm. And secondly, and as importantly, they help to trap and capture the residue and pin it into the soil surface so that we don't lose that residue from wind erosion. Although vertical till tools don't look that aggressive, they do take a decent amount of power because of their operating speeds. Ideally, a vertical till tool will operate between 8 to 12 miles an hour, and if you've got any type of additional terrain or slopes, then you're going to have additional horsepower needs there as well. At a bare minimum, we recommend a minimum of 10 horsepower per operating foot of your VT tool in order to provide the basic functions in a relatively level field condition, and certainly recommend going up to 12 to 14 horsepower per foot if you've got terrain and slopes to deal with.